tries to control things financially by way of amendments to Motor Vehicle Act. This is our case nowadays. How many of us feel that these amendments were not required? Any one of you? Were they required?
Yes, sir.
For whom?
For us.
For us only. In India, around 1.5 lakh persons are dying on roads. In every 4 minutes, we have an accident. And 3% of our GDP is being spent on these cases. And what I felt after these amendments came place, what I felt that people have started stopping their vehicle before stopping. Otherwise, in old days, when somebody has stopped his vehicle prior to the stop line, then after 60 or 70 seconds, he would be 20th to control that signal. Somebody will come over in front of him. Now this is the impact of these heavy challenges that people have started following law. People have started getting their PUC done. And this is the impact of these heavy challenges that pollution level has gone down. So therefore, in media, we are seeing that there are many propagandas going on. That the government is hell-bent upon to prosecute the public at large. Are we waiting for doing something wrong? We should not. This is for our safety. So being a legal professional, being a student, being a son, you need to send across this message that these amendments are for our safety. We need to follow the law. As we are following other laws, we need to follow Motor Vehicle Act also, in letter and spirit. Right? And sir has already discussed all the activities of DSLSA, and I have requested sir to organize another session on a particular subject. Today we have a brief introduction of DSLSA and activities. And if we want to organize another session on any particular subject, like POPSO Act, like DGL, or ABC, then we will have another session. Right? Thank you. God bless you all.